No animals outside. No animals outside. He's used to it. He always falls. You didn't spray this room? No. I always have the cat food in here. I've never seen ants in this room. The ants are in Chance's room because there's a door to the outside and like all the places that are attached to outside doors. Yeah, no, he doesn't need to spray in here. Thank you though. So I was hot in. There's like animal spray people coming in. Yeah, it was hot in. Salt on popcorn. Dude, I love popcorn. It's so yummy. Popcorn is the best. Dude. There. Raynad said you're right, he is awkward. I mean, I feel bad though. It's like he doesn't have to be awkward. He makes situations more awkward than they need to be, you know? It's like they don't need to be like that. They really don't. They don't need to be like that. He's telling Aaliyah a story. It's fun. You can tell me whatever story. All my stories from DreamHack, nothing of it is that crazy or bad. Like, really, nothing of it. Nothing. Attention whore. That's, well, welcome to, like, 90% of Twitch. Everybody says that. No, I didn't do anything with Chance. Should I bother trading? I guess I'll trade. Let's do this and this. It's okay if he calls me attention whore. What? Okay. Wow. He's a... I don't think Raynad is any bad mom. He's 22 years old. I cannot actually hold any of the things, actions that he did accountable to him because he's 22. He's a 22-year-old guy who suddenly became famous and into a lot of money, and I'm pretty sure that's how any 22-year-old act. I don't know. I really can't hold anything against him except for one thing that happened where I just like blew my mind. You can tell a story. You can keep me informed on it. So mature, 25. Dude, I am mature, man. I'm 25. My emotional maturity is a lot higher than someone who's 22. I remember how I was when I was 22. We flirted for a month. Maybe time goes by slowly? I don't know. Girl. Oh, cool. A healing totem. It's true. I stole his audience? Right, that's why I get so many viewers. Leah uses Twitch like a cow. Yes, of course I do. Obviously. Dude, 3 years is different. Do I like 40-year-old men? No. I don't think so. He's telling a story. Oh, you know what? I could tell you a story too. But I won't do it. I'll try not to. I have like a 12-year-old, cool. He didn't send it to all the Snapchat! Where's the Snapchat? I would never send a topless Snapchat to anyone. Play this. Where is it?
It's ecstasy in both our eyes.
Can we go sub mode? No, man. I ain't scared. This is stupid. No, I didn't send any naked Snapchats. Are you kidding me? Topless? What am I gonna show off? My nipples? You think, like, my boobs or something? I'm like, oh yeah, this is what the boys want. Like, let me fucking take a selfie in the mirror with my fucking boobs out. No, I'm not gonna do that shit. That's some bullshit right there. You think my tits are worth anything? No, that's not what I do. My personality carries me. Oh yeah, this is wonderful. Dude. I honestly barely talk to Rayned. I talk to him, like, I played, like, 3 league games with him, and they're always with a group of friends. I invited him to Amsterdam, because I was literally inviting everyone to Amsterdam, not just him. I was inviting everyone that I knew who was going to DreamHack to Amsterdam. 8. 11. 11 and 6. That's 17. Right, I think that's lethal. Yeah, I win. And I wasn't talking to Chance. Chance was actually, like, mad at me. He, like, barely talked to me ever. That's, well, wow, thank you. I am dumb believing for all this? Well, you know, I have other things. Yeah, I did deny him, man. I didn't want to go into, I don't just, like, randomly have sex with people I don't really know. Like, no, I'm not gonna do that. No, I'm not gonna do that. Like, I think he, like, was looking for it. I'm like, no, and you're, like, so thirsty. I can't take it. It's, like, awkward as shit. Like, caca, go away. No. I was just like, god damn, no. I did make out with him, yes. Rayned and I made out. That was it. That's all that happened. We made out. That was it. That's all that happened. I stopped it. Whatever was happening, I was like, it ended. You wanna know how the making out session ended? $2 from Calm Your Tatas. I'm watching both stream chats, making both, and investigate the drama. The real story is not both of you, stream chat. You should subscribe to People Magazine and stuff. Yeah. Well, anyways, yes, we made out. This is all that happened between us. Literally some making out. Okay? He was, like, the first person I made out with in, like, 6 months, okay? And then I was just like, meh. No, thank you. No more, por favor. What's this? Just a regular weapon? Let's just totem. That's all I remember. That's all that happened. Kitty, no. Stop it. That's on signal. Just because you make out with someone doesn't mean you have to go take a home run, man. What's wrong with you? Dude, I don't care if he tells the story about what happened. Yeah, it did happen. Then Chance gave me his look. And I was like, yes, okay. Oh, shit. This is awesome. Oh, it turns it to 6? Aw, ball sack. I'll play this then. I thought I could play this if I coined. Never mind. Sometimes you do things and then you realize there are people. God damn it. What does that say? Josh, you had sex. You had stairwell. No, I did not have stairwell sex. I did not. I did not have stairwell sex. I kissed someone in a stairwell. Let's just play this. What are the chances of 2 assassinates? He made out with me! He also made out with someone else that same night! That's why I didn't think it was a big deal! How am I supposed to think it's a big deal that we made out when he made out with someone else literally in the same night? It's not that big of a deal! I'm like, oh, alright, it's cool. I got him another girl, because I literally grabbed another female, I won't say who it is, and I pushed her towards him, and I was like, you guys make out, and I kind of snuck away, because I was done with that situation, so I was just like, hey. So he had someone else, I got him another female to go to bed with, he shouldn't have been mad. So it's like, you shouldn't be mad at me, I made sure he was covered. Because I wasn't gonna let him in my room. No way. I think I was very nice by finding him someone else. It was really not my bad. I'm not mad either. I don't really like getting these cards. I'd rather have like my other bitches, like the lightning storm and the other. You know what I'm talking about, right? I think I want to do this. Just hit him in the face the next time I can play this. Let's go with how mad is Raynad. I don't know, man. It's not my problem. Oh, I forgot that this happened. Let's do that. Oh, shit. I forgot that that would happen. Let's just kill that. Okay. There we go. It's good. Judge, alright, well, see, there's it because he consumed too much PJ salt. I don't know, man, not my problem. Wait, if I would have done that, that's just your weapon, right? Okay, let's just do this and kill that. I wonder if that would have stacked with Rockbiter? No, it's just your weapon, right? Yeah, just the weapon. Turn this down. There we go. Now I'm actually finding out. I think it's finding out. Dude, all I know is I wingmaned for him like any good wingman would do. Not my fault if nothing worked out for him. That blows. Just throw it down there. Oh shit. Everybody knows I took shrooms. I already told you guys that. I didn't break up with Raynette. I wasn't ever dating him. I didn't ever date Raynette ever. Okay, you wanna know something? I could drop a nuclear bomb of a story. I don't know why Raynad wants to get into this. It's just like, why are you doing this, you idiot? Don't make me do this. Should I risk that? Let's just throw this down, hit him in the face. Anyone that gets into it? I have nothing. Okay. Do you guys want to know how thirsty Raynette is and maybe why it may have been a turnoff for me to be around him? I just feel like such an asshole. I would feel like such an asshole. I don't want to... Oh, God. God. I just feel like, Dude, all I'm gonna say, I was a wonderful... Play this. If I hit this, hit that, 3, 4, he might consecrate. Join the dark side? I don't know, man. God damn it! I was worried about that! Fuck! Now I'm gonna trade. Whatever. Load the cannon, fire the shots. Well. I just feel like. I've been. Just do this. I guess I could have done that first. See what happened. Nice telling story about it's fine. My stories are nothing bad. They're nothing bad compared to the stories I have on him, man. Raynette is the type of guy where you're hanging out in your bedroom with another girl, and he comes in and says, "Do you guys want to see card tricks?" And we say, "Sure." And he says, "Hold on, I'll be right back." Goes into the living room of the apartment you're staying in and turns on the song, "Let's Get It On," where we can hear it. And me and the girl look at each other and start cracking up. We're like, "Did he really just put that song on?" And he comes back into the room to show us card tricks. That's the kind of guy Raynette is. So I think everybody can understand when I say, I'm just not interested in Raynette, okay? That's one example of the stories that I, like, okay, that's not even the bad story, but that's just an idea of, like, the type of guy Raynette is. Throws on that fucking song to, like, show his stupid card trick, and he comes in, he's like, pick a card, any card, and I'm just cracking up the whole time because I can't believe that he thinks that this is gonna work, right? Like, it's just like, are you fucking kidding me right now? Like, this is, you're like, what the fuck are you talking about? Okay, so, anyways, that's, like, the least of the stories that I can say. of Raynette. Like, bro, can you just stop being such an imbecile? Like, just, can we just chill and not have everything be like a sexual innuendo? Why are you hitting my guy? That's so annoying. I'll kill that. Hope I just clicked the right thing. Hit him in the face. Card tricks are awesome. What the fuck are you laughing about? No, but it's the song that Leah in front of me has X on Christopher. What are you? No, I was already broken up with Hudson. You sound super salty. It's actually, it is funny, but he was serious. It wasn't like he was doing it to joke around. He was like being serious about it. One thing, Raynette literally. God, I can't say it. It's so fucked up. I would be such an asshole if I said anything. Raynette's pickup lines at a bar to try to pick up girls. I watched it. Well, I didn't watch it. Somebody else watched it and told me later, like, man, trying to wingman for Raynette is painful because all he does is walk up to girls and talk about how much money he has. And he says to girls, "I have so much money, I don't know what to do with it." Like, that's his opening line to pick up on girls. I don't want to say any of the shit that, like, I actually saw. Because I'm In a way, I feel like I should just say things, but in many ways, I just feel like this would be like, I can't stoop that low. I just can't stoop that low. I just can't. I can't. This. Can I just kill this? I thought this would be 4 damage. Now let's kill this. Let's just drop another one. Cause maybe I'll get some shit. He's destroying me. Well, you wanna know something? Oh god, I can't say it. I can't. Every time I get the balls to say it, to try to say something, I can't do it. Am I allowed to say it? Hold on, let me ask NMP Lol what he says. Hold on. Damn it, NMP the LOL isn't even here. I can't even like man, if I say it, I'm gonna be such an asshole. I don't like being an asshole. And I can't take it no more. I'm gonna have to kill both guys to kill that. If I just do this though, it's 3. That's not enough mana now. I could just ignore it. Maybe I'll just ignore it. Let's kill this. And kill this. And drop that. Man, I'm waiting for Nick. If NMP Lol told me just say it, I would just say it. Oh shit, if he's just gonna tell the story himself, that's fine. Oh! He's gonna tell the red light district story? Okay, if he's gonna tell anyways, I'll just tell it. So, Raynad, me, Kitty Plays Games, and everyone, I thought maybe the hookers in the red light district just kinda like dance for you, like they would do like on my free cams when you go into a private showing. Hold on. I think I can kill this. If I hit him in the face. Hit him in the face. Oh fuck! No! I grabbed the wrong thing! Oops. I grabbed the wrong thing. Well, now this game's over. So I just thought, you know what? Maybe. On pause. I was like, you know what? I thought that. So, anyway, so it was me, someone else, and Raynad, and 2 other people. And we're like, okay, well, this hooker. I thought we were gonna go into the back room, and I'm like, you know what? I just wanna see what happens. That was my point of view. We go into the back room, and the woman tells us, all of us, to sit down on a bed. And I sit down on the bed, and I immediately get up, and I'm like, I am not sitting on this bed. And there was a chair in the corner, and I went and sat down on the corner in this chair. And the woman tells everyone on the bed, she's like, okay, now everybody drop your pants. Let's just say, you know, everybody but one person decides to take off their pants and let it all out. And then that person looks around and realizes nobody else took their pants off, because who the fuck takes off their pants for a hooker? Because she's a fucking hooker. And then that person proceeded to let this hooker tug on their flaccid penis and then suck on their penis without a condom on, mind you, HPV, herpes, etc. And I'm just sitting in the corner like, oh my god, what the fuck am I watching right now? And I stand up and I'm in the corner and I have my hat on and I'm just like, oh my god, is this happening? And then the hooker puts a condom on that flaccid penis, and that person keeps looking around saying, hey, I thought you guys were gonna join in. I thought we were all doing this. And I'm like, dude, no, nobody's gonna fucking do this, you retard. And I'm like cracking up because I can't believe what the fuck I'm watching right before my eyes. And then that hooker decides to take off her top and get all on top of that person who had their pants down, the one person that decided that it was a good idea. And he keeps looking around saying, this isn't turning me on. I thought everybody else was doing it too. And it's like, no, man, nobody's gonna do this. And then I left the room because I was like, holy shit, I can't believe this is happening. They like touched his dick without a condom on with their mouth. And I left the room. And 3 minutes later, that person came out of the room and said, I've never disappointed so many females in one room. I'm so mad at you guys because I thought we were all doing this together. And I was just looked at him like, why are you so horny all the time? And I was just like, yeah. So that's the story. And it's just like, after that, I just realized, man, I want nothing to do with this person. Because that's really fucked up. I don't want anything, like, there's no way ever. Like, especially the whole, like, mouth to penis, no condom thing. Like, that's so bad. I would never, ever, ever do something like that. I don't know, maybe because I have a science background and I know how, like, STDs perpetuate and it's just, like, all over the place. Like, it's, like, 51% of the population has HPV and herpes. And, yeah, that's just not into that, man. I'm just like, you guys can all hail it, man, but, dude, that's too gnarly for me. I can't, I'm not gonna do that. No way, no how. Not into it. I'm not down with the hookers. I just thought she was just gonna dance for us, like in my free cams when you go to a private show, or like masturbate in front of you. But it was like legitimate, she was gonna fuck us and want us to take our pants off. And I was like, no, I'm not taking my pants off. No, no. I stood in a corner and I was laughing the whole time as somebody got molested and let it happen. So, I don't know, man. I'm just not into that. I'm not gonna get down with that. Not into it. Who the fuck gives a BJ with a condom? It's a hooker, man! Imagine how many BJs they give a day. Why would you ever not have that, man? That's scary. That's terrifying. Are you kidding me? Imagine how many other people they gave non-condom BJs to. And their mouths. You know you can carry HPV and herpes in your mouth? They're starting to discover patients now coming in with throat cancer. And when they take the sample of it, it turns out that it's from HPV and herpes. It's terrible. What else would you do? Go with your immature woman friends. I guess I'm a baby man. I'm not doing that. Stop insulting the hooker. It's a hooker. A hooker is a hooker. They get tested a lot. Okay, that makes up for it. You think brushing your teeth gets rid of HPV and herpes? Are you kidding me? What, does that mean if I brush my vagina with a toothpaste and a toothbrush, it's gonna get rid of herpes? No way. Dude, that is pretty disgusting, right? Who would do that? You think I'm paranoid? Well, you know what? I have been tested every single year. I have always been STD free. And I'm proud of it. Nothing wrong with not wanting to do that. Dude, safe sex is important. HPV and herpes can lead to cancer in all of your orifices. Your mouth, your anus, your vagina, all of them. You can get cancer that way. Can't blame him for going for the 5 slam. Oh man, I just couldn't believe that he was actually like fell for it. It was honestly the greatest troll of my life, I feel like, because he went in there with us with a completely different state of mind than what like everybody else was thinking, and he was the only one that took off his pants, and I was just like, whoa man, whoa, like, is this happening? It honestly took me 3 days to realize how gnarly it was. That's the best word I can think of. It was just gnarly. And I was like, in the corner and giggled about it until I left the room. Condoms are a waste. PK Jason, stop. No way. So there you go. That's the story. Leah, you just said without a condom, but he was a virgin. It's different. It's a virgin. A virgin? Like, come on. That's safe. Who the fuck sucks a dick with a condom? A hooker should! Someone whose job it is to take dicks in their mouth all night. I did see his penis, yes. I saw his penis because he took off his pants and like the hooker was fucking touching his limp dick right in front of me. And I was just like, whoa! Whoa! This escalated quickly. How'd this even happen? You know, like, Jesus Christ. I don't know if it's 8.5 inches. It was like he was on a bed. It was like a room the size of half of this room.